Okay, we're at Skyline on Tuesday. Is it Tuesday? It's Tuesday.
Tuesday.
Amter and I. You haven't been to Skyline.
Thanksgiving.
Thanksgiving. We did Diablo, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, we're gonna do Trencherous today, which is like mini Diablo and lower block, which you've done before. But I'm debating. Do I put the GoPro on backwards and get you?
You don't want that. It'd just be nothing but laughs.
Oh. All right. So, yeah, there's nothing really tricky on this. Just follow my line. Yell if you want me to go faster. That boy is dry. Steer wide. I see you hiking. This trail is kind of messed up in the dry, huh?
It's real slippery. Yeah. It's loose.
The golf ball size rocks.
You get in those rocks, it's like a long rock slide down.
Yeah. I always wonder why there's a lawn chair in that turn.
Yeah, who the hell brought that up?
Yeah, some gay hiker. That chute right there, I rarely ride down the crack. I'm always going.
I got in a spot and I buried my front
and
over the bars. And I reached my hand out and I pushed myself back up and tipped over.
Yeah, she's a little loose right now.
Yeah, it is very loose.
Crazy how these shrubs have closed in on the trail since the last time I rode here. Especially right here. This is the Mattia turn right there.
Oh, shit.
That turn back there is the Mattia turn.
Oh, that's what he fell off
of? He flew off into the bushes. So right here, goes left and down, and that's the last steep. This one is deluxe in the wet. Go to the right of the rut right there.
Above the rut?
To the right, above it. And then you drop into it down here. And down here, go to left. Yeah, back there, the right over the rut and left of the rut is pretty important. This is right here.
This is where I wish I had flat pedals.
I don't remember what this is. This is pretty steep, but it's not bad. Good play on the KTM.
Fucking whore.
See? See? We are mechanical experts here at SML. If that was a Harley part, it would go on easily.
In minutes.
With American bolts. 3/4 inch.
We got enough American footage.
Hector.
I come from across the border. I'm here now.
Kind of pointless, I guess.
Does CVAC help burns?
Helps kind of everything, really. Mm-hmm. And especially with me, like with the kind of hit my head, obviously, when I crashed. So.
Yeah, that's good for concussions.
Yeah,
huh?
Yeah, so I was going there mainly for that. But I think kind of just everything. Damn, I pinched that.
I figured out a strategy. What's if that? You take a sandwich from Old Market Grill, mm-hmm. and give it to JC.
Yeah.
He gets so pumped, he starts eating it, and you can just jump in the pod.
Well, I haven't even been telling him I'm coming. I've just been going. Yeah, I just go and I just start it. Because I'm like, dude, I can't deal with this. I don't want to add another hour to my day. Yeah.
Hey, so on the show, are you going to show your skin graft on your butt?
Can.
Yeah?
Whatever.
Drop the pants?
Yeah, sure. I can. I'll get with it. I ain't scared.
Show stay Mikey.
What's up, Don?
What's up? How are you?
Good to see you.
I haven't seen you in a while.
Yeah, it's been a while.
What, over a year, right?
At least.
Because you've been in Florida?
Well, I think
you moved to Florida.
Yeah, I'm in Florida full time now.
You like it?
I love it.
Do you?
Yeah.
Come on, dude. Yeah. You're a California kid.
I was born and raised here, but I'm a Florida boy now.
Floridian?
Got my wife, got my two girls.
You like the heat and humidity there?
I do. I love it.
Do you really?
I love it.
I don't know.
There's nothing better than being able to wake up, you know, in the morning and be in a bathing suit from the time you wake up till the time you go to bed all day long.
I guess.
It's pretty sweet.
Too many bugs, dude.
Yeah, the bugs,
They like teriyaki flavored blood, I think.
I mean, at the end of the day, honestly, like, they don't even bug me anymore.
Yeah.
The bugs don't even bother.
They get used to you and they quit bothering you, huh?
Well, the thing is if you eat a lot of sugar, that's what they're attracted to.
I don't need a lot of sugar.
So.
I'm just naturally sweet, dude.
Well, there you go. You're just too sweet.
So, this is the old Jack McGrath.
That's what I was just told.
Muffler shop. Yeah. So we're here with Jeremy. I didn't win that check on the wall. So how was two-stroke practice?
Good.
Yeah? What are you riding?
Both 125 tubing.
Hondas?
No, the Yamaha. Blends all bike.
Uh-huh.
Yamaha, my dad's bikes.
Oh, nice.
So
same bikes you raced last year?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yeah. We tried to do the Eddie Sanders thing, but
I remember that thing.
After
yeah.
I like bankrupted him $30,000 2 years ago, he's like nowhere to be seen. So can't get a hold of him. I don't even know if he's alive.
Took his bonus?
I don't know, man. He just went off the face of the earth and it was weird.
That bike was pretty sick though, huh?
It was pretty sick, but you know what? Varner's building one that I think is equally as good or even better.
Yeah. That's not what you're racing this weekend, right?
It is, yes, sir.
Oh, so he's still building it right now?
Yeah, Varner.
Oh, that's typical Varner fashion, huh?
We've been tinkering with it till like 2, 3 in the morning, whatever it takes, and we're pretty happy with it right now. It's like almost 60 horsepower.
Out of a 252 stroke?
Yeah.
Is it a 300?
It's a 275.
275.
Yeah.
Still, that's gnarly, huh?
Yeah. He knows what he's doing. That's one thing about Varner. He knows how to tune a two-stroke.
Really raced...
My era was right from 85 Super Mini straight to the 450. Yeah. 450. Because I went to Loretta's in 03, won all my classes, and then the very next week I went right to a 450.
Yeah.
And then a year later from Loretta's in 04, I was making my debut at Millville.
Yeah.
Literally, a year later. So it's kind of crazy to think in 365 days I went from a 30 horsepower motorcycle to almost 60 horsepower. So it's crazy.
What do you think? Do you think that you're, you missed out on a two-stroke big bike? Or like when you ride it right now, you're like, I'm glad you didn't ride it.
I ride a two-stroke really good.
Yeah.
I really do. I feel like that was maybe a better era for me as far as maybe going pro.
Uh-huh.
But who's to say that would have or wouldn't have? I mean, it's...
How often do you ride two-stroke? Once a year for this thing?
I mean, pretty much. It's just this race.
Yeah.
I mean, I love two-strokes. It's just the era right now is four-strokes. Yeah, that's the world we live in right now.
What do you think about electric? Have you ever ridden Alta? No? Yeah, we're going to Spain next month to ride the Stark.
Mm.
I'm actually a little worried about looping out or something.
No, you'll be fine. You'll be fine. All right, we're
at Jacob Johnson. Are you like the producer, filmer, editor, everything of the above?
A little bit of all of it, yeah. The main title would be director of photography, and then I did all the editing for all the action sequences. So, it was a cool journey. Tyler's insane on a motorcycle, so that was a treat in itself. But it was cool. It was cool. I'm glad to finally see it come out. It's been a long time.
How long has it been in the works?
I want to say maybe a year and a half, 2 years.
Oh, wow.
I want to say.
Long one.
But I could be completely cooked on that and be wrong. But, yeah, it's been a long time, it feels like. But, no, it's cool to finally see it come out. And,
Yeah, so and it's probably a bit of a passion project because Tyler's your buddy too, right?
Yeah, so that was, like, one of the things that when Tyler hit me up, I was like, dude, absolutely. Like, just you're the homie, and, like, there's no one I'd rather do it with and spend that much time with, to be honest. Yeah. So, yeah, no, it was cool.
What was it like as an editor working with, like, all the old footage? I'm sure that's in this, right? There's got to be old flat track stuff.
So I didn't have to touch a lot of that stuff because I did all the action stuff. So all the action stuff was shot by me.
Uh-huh.
So all the stuff I edited was my stuff and like some previous stuff. So I didn't have to touch on all the old stuff, but
Awesome. Did you do all the interviews and everything then?
Yeah. All the interviews.
Oh,
yeah.
Nice.
Yeah.
So you're fully entrenched in this project.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. Cool. It's like I said, it's been a cool journey. So I'm glad to see it.
Well, nice. I can't wait to see it. And congrats on the project, buddy.
Thank you.
So we're at the Tyler Bereman. Was it called The House That Built Me?
House That Built Me.
Is that a play off The House of Gucci?
I think it's a play off of a song.
Oh. Okay.
But, I mean, whatever. Call it what you want.
We're at the premiere. Have you seen it already?
I've seen it. Tyler and I watched it together.
Oh.
It's,
Did you cry?
I cried, and I laughed.
Yeah.
And I went back and forth a couple of times. Mm. It's pretty cool. It's really cool. Obviously, I grew up with Tyler and... Mm-hmm. and you know, I was close with Captain Ron and Randy and, you know, through the whole video, goes through so many different parts of his life. And I was lucky enough to be there for most of it. And it's just been a really cool experience. So I'm glad that they're kind of putting it out there and we're all going to be able to see it. It's
Frankie,
awesome.
Can we talk about this hat?
Yeah. What about it? What do you want to know? What do you want to know?
Remember that show, The Three Amigos?
Yeah.
The movie with Steve Martin?
No. Oh, yeah, I do. I do.
I mean, what is this hat? Is this a cowboy hat? Is this a bolero hat?
Call it what you want. It's,
Do you have, like, a signature way to put it on your head?
No.
Like, flip it?
No, I mean, I should do that. I should do that.
Yeah?
Just get into something.
What do you think of his hat, Joe?
I have my moments with it.
Yeah. I mean, as his trainer, what do you think of his hat?
You know, sometimes I tell him to take it off, and I don't know. It just depends on the outfit of the day.
Yeah.
You know, and those are ever changing.
Does it work with this kit?
Wait, let's talk.
I think it works. Yeah.
Are these the largest white skinny jeans in existence?
They are.
Huh?
They are. Yeah. 3430.
3430?
Got them off Amazon.
Are you in a 34,
yeah,
really?
Yeah.
Come on, dude.
I swear.
Yeah?
You want to see the tag?
No, I don't, right. I don't need to
I'll
see
take these pants off. You don't need to. I'll take these pants off your pants.
Dude. Oh, so, boy. So I have an Italian friend named Mattia that's always wearing white jeans.
Uh-huh.
I mean, I figure that's a Euro thing, you know? But what?
He's a cultured guy.
Yeah, I'm a very cultured individual. The rules were black and white. Guess what?
Oh, yeah. Oh, I forgot about that.
Yeah, you blew it.
I always wear black.
Yeah, well, you got camo, so that doesn't matter.
Yeah,
a little yellow. But, I mean, it just goes with the skin tone, huh?
Yeah. Well, I'm black on the inside. My soul is black, right?
Yeah. No, we get it.
All right. Have you seen this yet, Joe?
I haven't. He told me a little bit about it. I'm excited.
Wait, are you guys roommates yet? I heard you...
We're not.
Frankie
yet.
And
we kind of are.
And Benny are gonna rent some mansion.
Well, we kind of. Nicole and I. Frankie stays with us right now. You know, whenever. You know, he can, and sometimes he doesn't come back out this way. But.
Okay. And you're not working at the prison anymore?
No. Nope. Racing motorcycles full time.
Oh, you bagger living.
Bagger racer. Okay. Bagger life, okay, dude. Okay. Yep.
Now, are you aware that your potential roommate Benny Tazi is Hell's Angel?
I heard there was initiation process. I didn't know what the what
is he the softest Harley rider ever?
We're talking physically or emotionally.
Both, all of the above.
Yeah, he's pretty much fits both those bills.
Yeah,
pretty clear. He's mad at me right now, actually, because he came over for lunch and Joe and I went to go get haircuts.
Uh huh. Oh, because you got haircuts without him?
No, because we were supposed to get lunch with him.
Oh. Okay.
And I guess he must have drove.
Have you worn his? Have you worn the Bleeding Hero shirt yet?
I didn't get it. I never got it.
Oh, it's in the locker of A-Ray's semi for you. Yeah, you didn't show up.
I gotta
up
go
that
to the Supercross race to get.
You didn't show up that day. That's why.
I did show up that day. We showed up very late.
Okay.
Yeah, he was with me.
Cooper Webb wears his all the time.
I want to wear it every day.
I want one of those.
Every time I hang out with Benny, I'm gonna wear that thing.
Yeah. He's the Wolverine. That's his new name.
Wolverine.
He says he heals like a Wolverine. The big day.
Big day.
So what this thing's been in works for a year and a half, Jacob says?
About two and a half was the time that we interviewed my grandpa. We kind of hopped on it, and then I put it on the back burner for a bit because I got busy and kind of kept coming back to it a little bit, and just stoked I got those interviews with my grandpa before he kicked the bucket. But
that is the gnarliest thing, to have somebody on video.
Yeah.
To watch over.
I mean, it's awesome though, because I'll hold on to that voice forever. You know what I mean? I got it on film, and that's kind of the last time before he got sick. So stoked to honor him. Like, obviously, he's not here to see this, but he lived it. So stoked for everyone else to kind of see my life in film. And stoked to get everyone together, have some fun. It's actually cool. Right over here, my dad has this Rotax C&J frame.
Uh-huh.
He blew this thing up 20 years ago. Sat on the shelf in my grandpa's shop.
Yeah.
Had the thing fully restored, rebuilt, painted photo on the tank from Chris Wood at Air Tricks with my dad and my grandpa at Ascot Raceway back in the day. So a little ode to my dad. I'm so stoked to watch him get out there and rip that thing. And he used to take me to the track on that thing and ride me around on the tank for opening ceremony. So,
okay, so I
circle.
Know that you started on flat track.
Yep.
Proportionally?
Yep.
What are you better at?
I'm gonna go ahead and say I'm better at jumping now. Yeah. I decided to stop turning left, but man, I can still give Pops a few laps of theory, you know? So I'm gonna get out there with him right now, go spin some laps.
Your gook ass
come
in
on,
here.
Come on, man. You press out the boat, they let your ass in.
Yeah.
Come on, man. You smell like soy sauce, dude.
Damn,
your
Dao.
Breath, dog.
Meet the Dao, you had the skinny jeans?
Eating that Kung Pao freaking
jeans.
Poodle? Come on, K-pop, baby, all day.
Are you on BTS? Are you one of the guys in BTS?
Any fucking guy.
Huh? Are you?
You're a manager.
Jet, is he smooth like butter? Huh?
You're so stupid, man. Oh,
so what up? What up? What up?
Chilling, man. How you been? Doing? Good, man.
You good?
Good, good. Yeah. Man, I miss you.
Did you get your green card yet?
No, hell no, dude. I got a yellow card.
Hey, G. Nice shirt.
What's up?
Hey.
Huh?
I like your shirt.
You like that? Huh? Live fast, die happy.
Do you live by that motto?
I'm kind of shy, so I'm like on my purse.
I was thinking about making a Swapmoto live shirt that says, do not resuscitate. That's my slogan. I say it at the top of the trails.
There you go.
Do not resuscitate.
Yeah.
So wait,
is that when you tuck the front, you're just...
Yeah, just done, right? So I heard you're like a new factory rider, or is that a secret still?
What? Factory rider?
You know, like ambassador kind of guy.
For who? I need to know.
A certain color.
What color?
What color is the light on the front of this camera?
Not that I've heard.
Oh, come on.
Green?
Playing silly. Playing silly.
Green?
Okay, wait. Why are you not racing the two-stroke race?
Well, a couple issues. Some that I kind of don't want to talk about, but just timing wasn't right. I didn't have the proper stuff that I needed to, you know, feel like, I mean, that caliber of racing now is not just like go out and have fun. So just had some little issues with the bike earlier in the week. Mm-hmm. Not saying that we couldn't have fixed that, but yeah, just.
I heard one blew up on the dyno or something.
I guess that did happen. I wasn't there for it.
Well, I have
it,
a bone stock YZTV that you're welcome to.
Yeah, but I don't want to get fifth or tenth, you know? Like, I want to go win, so. I don't know. We're just, it is what it is.
You put the forks off my 450 on it.
I've been looking for forks and a shock. We actually
called your brother. I don't think the 450 shock will work, but no. The forks will.
So, I mean, but it's good. Like, we're just, I don't know, hanging.
Yeah.
Trying to make it work, but there might be some new stuff coming. Like, I'm pretty stoked. It'd be kind of cool.
Put your ass
how's
the
mini
dad
like?
That is, like, wide open. That's, like, the gnarliest thing I've ever done.
I remember you were
like, I thought racing was hard, but, like, they're a lot harder than going to race on Saturday nights now. Now I'm like, dude, what did I do?
Are you a gnarly mini dad?
I can be.
Do you throw shit?
No, I don't. No, I shouldn't say that. I have, but...
Yeah, just so
that's
you know,
the problem with that whole industry or that part of it is that like you get sucked into it. You want them to do so good and
you put that much effort into it.
Yeah, and then you're like, you know, just little dumb stuff that like makes it hard. But like, I don't know, I'm still having fun with them. I don't push them that hard. Like, I'm not forcing them to go race or do that. Like, they're wanting to do it on their own. So, but it is like, I don't know, like four full-time jobs. It's insane.
So wait, if you're not at two-stroke race,
no, I'll be
Cal
there.
Classic?
No, we're still racing the two-stroke.
Okay. Oh, the
boys want to go race, yeah. So obviously, you know, with Fast Alice and our deal with them, like it's been cool to kind of link on and do that. I mean, I enjoy it, and the boys want to race Glen Helen. They love that track, so.
Just we're gonna like
make
that.
Yeah, they're going to make like that their new house.
So how about Ash? Is she a gnarly mini mom?
No, she's like the opposite. She's like, you guys go do your thing, and then I'm just going to like not watch because I can't take this anymore. Okay. She's like, when you got hurt, no big deal. But with them, it's a different story.
Yeah. It's nerve-wracking.
So.
Hey, it's more people going to Cal
Classic. Enjoy that.
Cheers.
Tell me about the stitches.
The stitches, well, we're 15 deep.
15 deep. And
two different wounds. Last week, he had a BMX accident and filleted his shin open and got 9. We got those out 2 days ago. And then today, he rode the little Razor electric bike straight into the backside of the Fresh Park ramp. Laid him between his fingers. Oh, I have like
kind of like dad's thumb and index
exactly,
finger.
Exactly. And he was only asking about it the other day. Like, oh yeah, no, it wasn't nice today, and that's kind of where we're at.
Yeah, I saw that on your story. And
so
like,
it's been an interesting, 10 days.
Yeah.
I was like, I'm really a good mom, I promise.
That social service is going to start questioning.
That's what I'm worried about.
Yeah.
Boys. Oh no. Someone's gotta just play golf. I swear, someone's gotta play golf.
Oh, are you kidding me? Not in your family.
I wish.
Susie?
Hi.
Listening to all these Stitches stories, are you glad that you have two little girls?
I am glad every day.
Have you had Stitches yet?
She's had Stitches a couple times, She's our boy. She's the closest to a boy we've had.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, I only make girls, Don.
Huh?
I only make girls.
You know what that means. It means it's short.
Yeah, well, it must be. But I ain't complaining. Look at these kids, dude.
Yeah.
They get all their looks from their dad.
Hey, when are you going to make it out to a race that you're a title sponsor of?
When I'm not busy working. We've been jumping at every round. Like, if we leave tomorrow to Atlanta, then we have Foxborough, Salt Lake, and then Paula. We're jumping at the Paula National now, too. So we've just been busy.
And you're doing the summer, then, all when Supercross is done?
Well, we might be jumping at a couple outdoors, too. So.
Yeah, but not all of them, not every one.
No, five or six of them are jumping at. So this, I was going to do the last race, and then a show came up, and I had to go. So, but, yeah, I want to come out and get some gate drops for sure.
Yeah. Dude, the DBK racers, Richard.
Dude, they're sick. I heard they've been going good.
Yeah, yeah.
That's rad. That's way rad. I just pumped their part of the series, dude. It's cool as hell.
What did
I see all the little kids.
About the, he came out and was selling shirts.
Yeah, it was good. It was a good weekend. It was sweet, yeah. We were trying to get out and try to go do a mini major, but all of us are out of town. Like Tyler, Wanky, Taka, Axel, all these dudes are in Japan for X Games, and they miss it too. And then I'm gone that weekend, so we're like trying to figure it out, but we're just busy right now. Yeah. And it wasn't like this last year, so it's been good. No complaints. Don. Hey, you quit crashing on your mountain bike?
No. I just got released.
Dude, what'd you do last? Your
collarbone.
Break it?
Yeah.
Did you get surgery?
No.
Does it still hurt?
No, I took the shit in my stomach.
Yeah. HGH. It works. Up a little faster. Every moto dude that fucking gets hurt takes that shit.
Okay, now.
Swap.
How are you, Rocco?
Good.
Are you riding a motorcycle yet?
No.
What are you gonna do when you're older?
Ride a motorcycle.
What do you want to do for a job?
A pilot license.
You want to get a pilot license?
Yeah. Ah, flyer. That's safer.
Fly planes? That's a nice jacket for flying planes. You look like a pilot already.
Okay, what's the latest?
What's the latest? What's the latest and greatest, Rocco? Crew's got stitches today.
Yep.
And what else? Tyler's movie premiere.
Yeah.
Castle. We built from, right?
What's the latest in the Robbie Madison world?
Oh, latest in my world? You know, I just did that thing in India. I separated my shoulder a day in the dirt, which is a bummer. I've been told I don't need surgery, so I'm going to work on that. And then we're working on some big plans. You know, same old, haven't changed.
Yeah.
Just need to get, we're getting close. The idea's there, we just kind of...
More really secret shit in the works.
Yeah, just some big plans, you know. I have like, I'm actually going to go race Nitro Rallycross next year.
Uh-huh.
I'm excited about that, doing the buggy stuff. I've got a game coming out with Ubisoft, so you'll be able to ride the water bike in the video game, which will be cool.
Oh, nice.
And, Tyler.
Oh, he's right.
Stomp the double. Yeah. Hopefully do a distance jump here again soon, too, so. Got a number?
Distance.
I do, but...
Secret for now.
It is. It's a big number.
Keep me posted.
All right, man.
You get one of those?
I would.
Huh?
I don't wear sunglasses.
What is it called? Crokies?
Didn't like the gator glasses used to.
He's a man of action right there. Are you a gnarly mini mom?
Define mini mom.
Like throw shit. Tell them when or you don't get dessert.
Oh no.
No?
No.
Yeah, Josh said you don't care.
I don't.
Huh?
No, I don't even watch them half the time.
How is the mini bike mom life though?
I thought I was gonna
get
out of it.
Yeah, I remember you thought you escaped the whole moto thing, but
I know I keep looking for that clip. I keep looking for that clip of Inside the Outdoors when I was saying I fear the day my kids tell me they want to race dirt bikes.
Yeah.
I can't find it. Davey Coombs took that off the internet, but just kidding.
It's fun having you guys out at our races.
Aww.
You know, especially with Grandpa. I love seeing him back out there.
No. Well, my kids don't listen to either Grandpa or Dad, so we're looking.
So is that where you come in?
No, we're looking for a trainer.
Oh, a trainer.
No, I'm kidding.
Okay.
I don't know. We're in it for the fun. That's why we'll do two-stroke. We're gonna do the two-stroke race instead of
Trail Classic.
Trail Classic. Like, keep it fun.
That's good. All right. So now, here in the vlog is where I'm gonna insert the old video with the J-Law bike.
Okay. Hi, I'm Ashley, and you're on transworldmotocross.com.
Thursday.
Welcome, Chase.
Chase and Renee. Got Greer. Gonna hit TMB. There's some debate over TMB, meaning Tagalog Mountain Bikers, which is the Filipino people.
Right.
Which would make sense because that's a Filipino flag right there on the sign.
Right.
And then someone else said it was Temecula Mountain Bikers. Temecula built it.
This is Marietta, guys.
Yeah, right? It's Marietta. I think it's the Filipino mountain bikers.
Yeah, probably.
They make it. They're making the trail. Although I haven't seen no Filipino guys that's good enough to ride this trail.
Oh my god.
I can make fun of the accent because my wife's Filipino and that's how my in-laws speak. You're going to go to the mountain biking? But to McDonald's to get a hamburger. I case that jump so hard my bike wouldn't shift.
Really?
Yeah. Thank you. One more bite. Wait, do that again. How do you ride in a clear lens like that? It's so sunny.
This ain't clear.
Yeah, it is.
Smashed him.
Conflict in the high desert.
Get a clue.
Oh my god, dude.
Oh, the girl's... Oh, it's a bug.
Yeah.